Okay, boleh clear tak? Nampak tak slide?
Nampak.
Nampak, madam.
Nampak, madam.
Okay. Okay, the last chapter. Okay, chapter 6, eigenvalues and eigenvector. Okay, at the end of this chapter, okay, you should be able to identify what is the eigenvalues and eigenvector. Okay, untuk ni, chapter 6. You can refer textbook lah, textbook page. Okay, textbook, page 265, eigenvalues and eigenvector. Okay, at the end of this chapter, okay, you should be able to identify, okay, what is the characteristic equation for a square matrix A to find the eigenvalues and the eigenvector. So, relate. Okay, in this chapter, you should also to solve the characteristic equation to obtain the eigenvalues of A and also find the eigenvalues and eigenvector relate to the linear transformation in chapter 5. Kadang-kadang dia ada relate dengan chapter 5 lah. Okay, first we look at the definition of eigenvalues. Okay, what is eigenvalues? Okay, eigenvalues. Okay, we let based on definition one. Okay, we let A be a square matrix, n by n matrix, and the scalar. Okay, alpha is called the eigenvalues of A. Okay, alpha, lambda is the eigenvalues of A. Okay, if there is a non-zero vector that satisfies. Okay, A times V equal to lambda V. So this one, lambda is the eigenvalues. Okay, A is the standard matrix, is a square matrix, n by n square matrix. Okay, A times V. V is the eigenvector. Okay, this one, eigenvector. Eigenvector is the vector V corresponding to lambda, corresponding to eigenvalues. There's a relationship between eigenvalues and eigenvector. So, V is the eigenvector. Okay, A times V equal to lambda V. Okay, use this equation. And also, okay, what is the eigenspace? Okay, eigenspace is the set of all eigenvectors corresponding to lambda. The set of all eigenvectors. Okay, we look at the example one to show the relationship between eigenvalues and the eigenvector. Okay, determine whether the vector u equal to 1, 2 and the vector v equal to negative 1, are the eigenvectors for a matrix A equal to, okay, 1, 1, negative 2, 4. Okay, find the corresponding eigenvalues. Okay, to find the corresponding eigenvalues, okay, we have to use the previous equation, AV equal to lambda V. Okay, we want to find this lambda. This lambda is the eigenvalues. Okay, so we multiply matrix A. Okay, then matrix A, 1, 1, negative 2, 4. Okay, multiply with the first vector, vector v, u lah, 1, 2. Okay, so we get, okay, 3, 2, 1. G. Okay, 3, 6. Okay, they must change. Huh? Okay, and then we want to find the lambda. Okay, we factorize. Huh? We factorize. 3. So factorize 3. 1 and 2. So equal to this one is AV lah. AV and AV equal to must be equal to lambda V. So this one is lambda 3 and V. V is 1, 2. V. So lambda equal to 3. Okay, the question is find the corresponding eigenvalues. So the eigenvalues, lambda, eigenvalues equal to 3. Okay, so therefore, V is the vector V, the vector U. Lah. Therefore, your conclusion. U, vector U. Or the eigenvector and the eigenvector. Eigenvector U equal to 1, 2, 1, 2. Is the eigenvector for eigenvalues for lambda equal to 3. Where lambda is the eigenvalues. Okay, prove the second vector V equal to -1, -1. Okay, so AV equal to lambda V. A1, 1, 2. Okay, we get the multiplication of AV equal to okay, -2, -2. Okay, then we factorize 2 with -1, -1. The AV, so the lambda is equal to 2 and 2. Therefore, V equal to -1 is the eigenvector for lambda equal to 2. Okay. Okay, if we can factorize this, V is not the eigenvector. There's no relationship between eigenvalues and eigenvector. Okay, and then how to find the eigenvalues? Okay, from the matrix A. Okay, first step, write the characteristic equation for matrix A. Okay, as determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. Okay, where A is the standard matrix, N times N matrix, matrix N times N is the square matrix. Okay, minus lambda, we want to find this lambda. We want to find this lambda. Okay, lambda times I. I is the identity matrix. Okay, depend on size of a square matrix. Okay, and then the determinant of this one equal to zero. Okay, and then second step, find the solution for lambda using the determinant concept. Okay, we look at another example. Okay, example two. Okay, find all the eigenvalues. Okay, check in dulu lah. Find all the eigenvalues. Soalan dia, find all the eigenvalues and corresponding eigenvector for matrix A. Equal to 1, 1, negative 2, 4. Okay, then determine the GM and AM. Ni saya akan terangkan nanti lah. What is GM and AM? Okay, first we find the eigenvalues. In first, soalan dia. Find the eigenvalues. So from the previous slide, we find these eigenvalues to equal to this equation. The determinant of A minus lambda I equal to zero. So A minus lambda I equal to zero. Determinant of A minus lambda I equal to zero. Okay, A, this one lah, A kan. Okay, so okay, 1, 1, 2, 4. Okay, minus lambda I, lambda times I. So lambda times with identity matrix. Identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1 lah. First, 2 by 2 matrix. So equal to 0. So we get the equation. Okay, so 1 minus lambda. Boleh ni 1. Okay, ni awak ni lah. Kita expand kan. Kita multiply lambda with the identity matrix. So we get 1 minus lambda. Untuk ni. First entry 1, 1, 1, 1. And then the second one, 1. Okay, and then negative 2 minus 0 lambda. So negative 2. Then 4 minus lambda. Okay, sini boleh sampai sini. Sini boleh sampai sini.
Boleh,
okay, madam.
Okay, then we find this. We find the determinant. Determinant of this one. So determinant AD minus BC lah. 1 minus lambda times 4 minus lambda. Okay, minus. So plus 2. Minus negative 2. Equal to 0. Then we expand lah this one. Eh? Okay, dapat? Expand lah. Ni kena expand. Awak kena buat solve the quadratic equation lah. 4 minus negative lambda minus 4 lambda plus lambda square plus 2. So equal to 0. So we get the quadratic equation. Okay, lambda square minus 5 lambda plus 6. So equal to 0. Then we can solve this quadratic equation using calculator. Okay, calculator boleh eh? You can tekan calculator ataupun boleh buat manual tu. So we factorize this one, this quadratic. Okay, we get lambda negative 3, lambda negative 2 equal to 0. So lambda equal to 3. Then lambda equal to 2. Okay. So the eigenvalues for this matrix A is lambda equal to 2 and 3. Eigenvalues. Eigenvalues. Okay. Okay, ada soalan?
Tiada.
Tak ada, eh? Saya tunjuk contoh ni dulu lah. Baru kita pergi kepada soalan lepas tu. Tak ada, eh? So, we look at, okay, how to find the eigenvector for corresponding eigenvalues. Okay, we look at this knot. Okay, to find this, to find the eigenvectors for corresponding eigenvalues. Okay, first step. Okay, to obtain the eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalues or corresponding to lambda. Okay, for every lambda, okay, solve this equation. Okay, A minus lambda I times V. Equal to 0. Okay, we want to find this V. V is the eigenvector. Ni V. V is the eigenvector. Okay, A minus lambda I times V equal to 0. And then find the solution for the homogeneous system. You have to solve the system of this homogeneous equal to 0. So tengok untuk ni, gunakan equation ya. A minus lambda I times V equal to 0. Okay, so okay, question corresponding the eigenvector for matrix A. So there is two eigenvalues. See? So you have to find the eigenvector for lambda equal to 3 and then find the eigenvector for lambda equal to 2. Ada dua dah. Okay, for lambda. Kita tengok yang kecil dulu eh. For lambda equal to 2. Okay, the eigenvectors. The equation for eigenvectors is A minus lambda in times V equal to 0. Okay, so we substitute the lambda equal to 2 into this equation. Ada sebenarnya daripada sini lah. Oh, you all akan dapat matrix dia ni kan. 1 minus lambda. 1 negative 2. 4 minus lambda. Times the vector. Vector we want to find. So ni vector x1 and x2. So equal to 0. Using this equation to find the eigenvector. Okay, then we substitute lambda equal to 2 into this system. We get negative 1, 1, negative 2, 2. So we transform this matrix representation into augmented matrix to solve the system of linear equation. So equal to 0. Okay, we want to find the x1 and then x2. Let's solve this using elementary row operation. Using ERO. Reduce into REM form. So into REM form, kita jadikan positive 1 kan, leading 1. So negative row 1. Transform into row 1. Then negative 2. Jadikan 0. So 2 row 1. Plus root 2. Zero. Okay, then solve this system lah. So first we identify the free variable. So the free variable is x1 or x2?
X2.
Tak ada leading one kan. So x2 is a free variable. So x2 equal to a. We let x2 equal to a, where a is any real number. Okay, then x1 equal to x2. Okay, we look at the first row lah. So x1 minus x2 equal to 0. So x1 equal to x2. So x1 equal to a. Okay, then, so we get the equation. So x1, x2 equal to, we get the eigen, so the eigenvector for lambda equal to 2, equal to a and a, where a is any real number. Problem pula. Slide awak ada cunting eh?
Ada.
Ada, madam.
Ada,
madam. Ada problem sikit eh. Saya stop dulu.
Ada, madam.
Suara clear eh? Nah, ni dia, dia.
Dia.
Pen saya ni dia, dia tu. Dia. Itulah. Ada musuh. Okay, dah tak ada jantung kan?
Dah tak ada dah.
Okay, tadi sebab sini. Okay. Okay, untuk yang ni awak boleh sama ada tinggal ni ataupun maksudnya eigenvector for lambda equal to 2. Go to this one. Ataupun awak boleh factorize ke lah, factorize A. 1, 1. Okay, so this one is the eigenvector AA or A times 1, 1. Eigenvector for lambda equal to 2. Okay, and then to find the eigenspace. Tadi kita ada tengok kan eigenspace kan ni. Eigenspace is the set of all vectors corresponding to lambda, the set of all vector. So that's why kat situ tadi kita factorize kan. Ni factorize. So yang kita nak tahu sebelum ni kalau kita factorize, kita nak cari dia punya basis kan. Nak belajar chapter 5 kan. So this one ni basis for eigenspace. Vector for the eigenspace is the set of all vector kan. The set of all eigenvector. So ni set dia lah. So basis for eigenspace. Oh, boleh mention juga basis for eigenspace or basis for eigenvector, itu sama je. Okay, equal to yang kita dah factorize kan. 1, 1. Okay. So tu baru untuk eigenvector for lambda equal to 2. Okay, for lambda equal to 3, sama lah, cara dia sama. Jadi yang pertama, for lambda equal to 2. Okay, for lambda equal to 3, okay, cuba solve sini. Okay. Cuba kat sini. Lambda equal to 3. Okay, masuk je dalam yang ni. Equation yang ni kan. Kita dah ada equation ni kan. Lambda 1 minus lambda kan. Substitute je. Lambda equal to 3. So you get negative 2. 1. Negative 2. Okay, 4 minus 3 is 1. So ni equal to 0. Tak payahlah nak tulis balik yang ni kan. Cara dia sama. Solve using ERO. Jadi kita jadikan dulu. 1. Negative 1 over 2. Oh 1. Okay, kalau laju ke boleh stop. Eh? Boleh bagi tahu. So 1. Negative 1 over 2. Okay. Kita jadikan. Negative 2. Itu 0. So, naik 2 row 1 plus row 2. Zero. Ini X1, X2. Okay, so ni dah in REM form lah kan. Row epsilon matrix form. Okay, so we can solve this system lah. So the free variable is X2. X2 juga free variable. So X2 let X2 equal to A. A any real number. So X1 equal to 1 over 2 X2. So equal to 1 over 2 A lah. Kita akan dapat the eigenspace equal to X1, X2. So equal to X1 is 1 over 2 A. And X2 equal to A. We can factorize A. About 1 over 2 and then 1. Where A is any real number. So this one ni dia punya eigenvector. Eigenvector for lambda equal to 3. Okay, ni eigenvector. Eigenvector for lambda equal to 3. So this one ni dia punya basis for eigenspace. Over 2 and then 1. Okay, ada soalan tak? Panjanglah kan dia punya solution dia kan. Biasanya kalau dalam final dia tak akan tanyalah awak nak untuk cari eigenvector tu, dia tak akan suruh awak cari eigenvector untuk setiap lambda. Biasa mungkin dia suruh cari the largest eigenvalues or the smallest eigenvalues. Salah satu lah. Okay, ada soalan? Saya habiskan contoh yang ni dulu, dan baru kita refer kepada soalan pasir. Okay, and then soalan dia lagi apa? Determine the GM and AM. Okay, so what is GM and AM? Soalan nombor dua tadi ni. Okay, nombor tiga yang ni. GM and AM. Okay, GM, geometric multiplicity, GM. Okay, GM is the dimension of eigenspace for the eigenvalue. For the specific eigenvalue. The dimension of eigenspace for the specific eigenvalue. So we look at the how many basis for the eigenspace ni kat sini kan. Kita tengok. Okay, ada berapa? So ada berapa kat sini? GM is equal to, so GM for eigenvector this one, so GM dia equal to 1. Okay, ada berapa set vector kat sini kan? Basis, kita tengok berapa number of basis for eigenspace. So ni ada satu set je. So GM equal to 1. Okay, for this eigenvector, for lambda equal to 3, so the GM also 1. Geometric multiplicity. GM is the geometric multiplicity. Okay, ada satu set je. Okay, and then we look at the algebraic multiplicity. Ini algebraic ni, AM. Okay, the algebraic multiplicity AM is the number of time an eigenvalue occur. Berapa kali eigenvalue tu ada lah kan? AM. So kat sini kita tengok, okay, eigenvalue yang awak dapat 3 and 2. So the AM for 3, for lambda equal to 3 equal to 1. And also the AM, the algebraic multiplicity for lambda equal to 2, also 1. Okay, ada soalan tak? Ini untuk ni. Ini penting kan untuk next subtopic nanti yang 6.2. Diagonalization. Kena tahulah beza, kena tahu beza AM and GM. Ini sekarang AM is 1 and 1 lah. Okay, ada soalan tak ni? Ada soalan? AM and GM boleh faham? Tak ada soalan? Boleh dengar tak suara saya?
Ada media.
Boleh.
Takut tak clear ke sekarang? Okay, satu. Jadi kita tengok contoh pasir. Okay. Okey, cuba kita tengok soalan pasia. Okey, kita tengok soalan ni. Okey, refer soalan pasia ke tutorial 6. Okey, number 1. Okey, biasa soalan ni dia macam ni je lah bentuk dia. Tak banyak sangat lah untuk chapter 6 ni. Okey, consider the matrix A. Okey, this one, matrix A, matrix 3 by 3. Okey, find all the eigenvalues of A. Find all the eigenvalues. Okay, for the eigenvalues, okay, we use the equation. Okay, determinant of A minus lambda I n equal to 0. So, boleh carilah A minus lambda I. Okay, saya buat kat sini je. Saya dah akan dapat apa? Okay, awak boleh tulis dulu lah. 0, 0, negative 2. 1, 2, 1. 1, 0, 3. Okay, minus lambda I. Dia dah akan jadi lambda 0, 0, 0, lambda 0, 0, 0, lambda. Equal to 0. So, you akan dapat negatif lambda 0, negatif 2. 1. So, 2 minus lambda 1. 1, 0, 3 minus lambda. So, equal to 0. Okay, sampai sini boleh?
Boleh, madam.
Boleh.
And then find the determinant of this one. Okay, so untuk determinant kita pilih column or row mana yang mudah kan? Yang ada banyak zero lah. So we choose this second column. Ni. Kita pilih second column lah, lagi senang kan? Sebab banyak zero. Okay, so positif, negatif, positif. Okay, ni positif lah. So, 2 minus lambda. Okay. Then, kita tutup ni dengan yang ni lah kan. So, akan dapat negatif lambda, negatif 2, 1. 3 minus lambda. So equal to 0. So you akan dapat 2 minus lambda. Okay, yang ni negative lambda times 3 minus lambda minus, so minus negative 2 plus 2 to 0. 2 minus lambda. Okay, yang ni biar aje dulu. So, yang untuk yang ni awak kena expandkan dia. Dia dapat negatif 3 lambda plus lambda square. Dia kena expand lah. Plus 2. Sebab kita expand dan kita boleh factorize lah. So, dapat apa? 2 minus lambda. Okay, factorize ni. Lambda minus 2. Minus 1. Okay, dapat ni. Ni awak kena. Kita dah expand, kita factorize. Factorize akan dapat ni lah. Lambda minus 2, lambda minus 1. Boleh tak sampai sini? So sini boleh?
Boleh.
Boleh. Boleh. Boleh. Boleh. So akan dapat lambda equal to 2 1. Dapat 2 kan? Lambda equal to 2 and 1. Boleh ni? Akan dapat lambda equal to 2 tu ada 2 kali. Ya, saya dapat yang ni lah untuk question A ni. Okay. Okay, next question B. Find the basis for the eigenspace corresponding to the largest eigenvalues of A, obtained in A, of matrix A. So the largest eigenvalue is lambda equal to 2. Boleh? Dia suruh cari eigenspace untuk lambda yang besar kan. So equal to 2 lah. Okay, to find the eigenvector, eigenspace, nak cari eigenvector lah. Okay, we use the equation A minus lambda I times V equal to 0. Okay, kita gunakan equation ni. So, awak substitute for lambda equal to 2. Dia nak largest eigenvalues kan? So, lambda equal to 2 lah. Masukkan dalam ni. Substitute dalam yang ni. Tadi awak dah dapat yang ni kan? Yang ni kan? Substitute lambda equal to 2. Cuba kat bawah ni. Okay, substitute dalam ni. Okay, substitute dalam yang ni akan dapat lambda equal to 2. Akan dapat negative 2, 0, negative 2. 1. Then 2 minus 2 minus lambda kan, substitute lambda equal to 2. 2 minus 2 equal to 0 and 1. So 1, 0. Okay, 3 minus 2 equal to 1. So ni equation ni yang ni kan. So equal to the augmented matrix equal to 0, 0, 0. Okay, dia akan dapat ni augmented matrix. Yeah, solve this system. Transpose this augmented matrix into RM form. So ini kita boleh jadikan leading one dia lah. Negative 1 over 2, row 1. Then you jadikan 0. Negative row 1 plus row 2. Ini pun negative row 1 plus row 2. Akan dapat 1, 0. Okay, dapat 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so tadi first column is S1, X2 and X3. Okay, first identify the free variable. Okay, so free variable apa? Yang tak ada leading one. Variable apa?
X2.
Variable apa?
X2.
S to N?
S string.
S to N, S to N. Kita tengok setiap row ni. Leading one kat sini untuk first row ke S1. Second row tak ada leading one. Third row pun tak ada leading one. Maksudnya yang tak ada leading one S2 and X3 lah. So X2, okay we let lah, boleh let. Like X2 equal to A and X3 equal to B. A, B and ni real number. So X1 equal to, okay so from first row lah. X1 equal to negative X3. Buat ke sini kan. So akan dapat X1 equal to negative B. So untuk ni awak akan dapat X1, X2 and X3. So equal to X1 is negative B, X2 is A, S3 is B. Okay, soalan dia nak basis for eigenspace. Basis, so basis awak kena factorize. Kalau dia soalan dia nak eigenspace je, awak boleh je sampai sini. Where A, B is any real number kan. Soalan dia nak basis ni kan. Kalau basis awak kena factorize kan lah A and B. So factorize, we factorize A. Okay, we get 0, 1, 0. Plus B. Negative 1, 0, 1. So the basis for eigenspace. Equal to ni lah. 0, 1, 0. And negative 1, 0, 1. Okay. Okay, ada soalan? Yang ni berapa? 5 markah lah untuk yang ni. Buat senaraikan ni 1 markah je sebenarnya. Basis score ni. Punya calculation ni 4 markah. Okay, ada soalan? Tak ada, boleh faham?
Boleh.
Boleh,
madam.
Okay, last question. Okay, state the algebraic multiplicity, AM lah, AM algebraic multiplicity and geometric multiplicity, GM, for the largest eigenvalue of A. So we look at the largest eigenvalue is lambda equal to 2, the largest eigenvalue kan. So the AM is the number of eigenvalue occur kan, AM. Jadi, so refer kepada lambda equal to 2 lah. AM dia. AM dia equal to apa? AM, the number of eigenvalue occur. So kat sini ada dua yang lambda equal to 2 ni ada berapa kali? Dua kali kan muncul kan? So the AM equal to 2 lah. So ada dua kali. 1 and 2. 1, 2. Dia ada dua tu ada dua kali yang muncul lah. So AM equal to 2. And the geometric multiplicity is refer to the number of bases, the number for eigenspace, basis for eigenspace. Ni, berapa ada berapa? Dua juga kan? So the GM equal to 2. Ni, so ni tadi AM equal to 2, GM equal to 2. Thank you. Okay, ada soalan? Okay, then untuk yang tadi GMAM, NAM tambah kat sini. Nak sini. Ada lagi satu untuk dekat textbook tu. Okay, tak nas ni tak ada dekat textbook. Awak boleh refer dia ada page tu. Atau refer theorem 5, page 275. Dia ada mention kat sini lagi. Ada satu lagi theorem ni. Saya tambah kat sini refer theorem. Boleh refer theorem 5. Kat sini ada lagi satu theorem. Textbook page 275. Okay, theorem tu mention GM, the geometric multiplicity is always less than or equal to AM. Theorem dia. GM mesti lagi kecil atau sama dengan AM. Untuk yang ni. Boleh tambah dalam nak soal. GM is always less than or equal to the AM, algebraic multiplicity. Untuk awak check je lah betul tak awak buat AM and GM awak tu. Ataupun kadang-kadang awak terlupa kan, terlupa GM tu apa, AM apa. Kita boleh nak check, kita boleh gunakan teorem ni lah. GM always less than or equal to AM. Okay, tengok contoh. Tengok lagi satu tutorial. Okay, tadi je. Okay, kita cuba tengok ni. Ini pun sama eh. Soalan ni sama. Soalan dia semua sama je. Find all the eigenvalues and eigenvector. Yang C ni untuk next subtopic. Buat ada lagi satunya ni. Contoh. Nombor tu. Okay, show that lambda equal to 5 is the other eigenvalue of A. Okay, ni boleh guna yang biasa lah. Masukkan dalam equation A minus lambda I. Kita sini. Ya, dia dapat apa? Negatif 2 minus lambda 3 negatif 9 0 1 minus lambda 3 0 4 2 minus lambda 2 equal to 0. Then we choose the first column. Solve this determinant. So negatif 2 minus lambda. Okay. 1 minus lambda Okay, use the first column. First column, mana ni? 3, 4, 2 minus lambda. To 0. 2 minus lambda. Okay, 1 minus lambda. 2 minus lambda. Minus 12. Dia expand yang ni untuk ni, the right hand side dia. Expand this one. 2. Negative 3 lambda. Plus lambda square. Minus 12. Dekat lambda square minus 3 lambda minus 10. Okay, ini apa? Dapat jelas tu boleh guna ke kereta? Negatif lambda negatif 2 dapat apa? 5. Ini dalam dah gitu. Jadi boleh fakturas saya dapat lambda minus 2. Lambda. Eh, lambda plus 2 eh. Plus 2. Lambda minus 5. Lambda square. Check it to 0. So kat sini dapat lambda equal to negative 2 kan. Negative 2. Negative 2. Lambda equal to 5. Negative 2 kat sini ada 2 kali ya. Eh? So kat sini kita tahulah lambda equal to negative 2 ni dia punya AM equal to 2 lah kan, macam yang tadi. Okay, boleh sampai sini. Tu tadi dah proof lah, show that lambda equal to 5. So, is the other eigenvalue of A. Ha, kita dah cari N ni, lambda equal to 5. Okay, ada soalan? Tak ada eh? Okay, B, find the eigenvector corresponding to the smallest eigenvalue of A. Okay, the smallest eigenvalue is lambda equal to 2. So, carilah lambda equal to 2. For lambda equal to negative 2. Soalan dia nak smallest kan? Masukkan yang eigenvector ni A minus lambda I times B equal to 0. Ha, boleh je terus substitute dalam ni. Dalam yang ni. Substitute lambda equal to negative 2. So akan dapat 0, 3, negative 9. 0, 1 minus negative 2. 3. 3. 0, 4. Okay, 2 minus negative 2 is 4. So, equal to 0. Okay, solve this system using ERO, elementary row operation. Okay, transform this into RM form. So, untuk RM form, kita mesti jadikan leading one kan? So, look at the first row. Okay, the leading one. Ni sebab dah zero. So, leading one mesti jadikan yang untuk next ni lah. One. So, we use the operation 1 over 3 row 1. So, 0, Okay, then below leading one must be equal to 0. Below leading one, bawah leading one mesti 0. So untuk yang ni, yang ni. Jadikan 0. So we use the operation. Okay, negative 3 row 1 plus row 2. Then negative 4 row 1 plus row 4 or row 3. Ini negatif betul kan? Negatif. Negatif. 9 plus 12. Dan jadikan ni 1 lah. 1. 1 over 12. 2. Yang bawah leading 1 0. Jadi 60 2 plus row 3. 0 2 plus row 3 transfer to row 3. Okay. So the x1, x2, x3. Okay, solve this system. Okay, which variable is free variable? Okay, yang mana free variable?
X1.
X1 kan? X2 and X3 ni leading one dekat sini. So dekat X1 and X2 and X3 leading one. So X1 is free variable. X1. So let X1 equal to A. A any real number. So X. Okay, look at the second row. Kita nak solve. So X3 equal to 0. For the second row. Then from from the first row, so x2 equal to 3x3 and 3x3 so equal to 3a 3x3 0 so x3 equal to 0. Okay, x2 equal to 3x3, x3 equal to 0. So, I can dapat the eigenvector. For lambda equal to negative 2, so equal to x1, x2, x3 equal to 1 is A, x2 is 0, 0. Boleh terus factorize lah. A 1, 0, 0. Where A is any remainder. Okay. Okay, dapatnya ni. Ini untuk B. Find the eigenvector. Markah? 5 markah. So, yang ni satu markah lah untuk yang ni. Segi pemarkahan kan. Ini satu markah. So, awak punya calculation ni 4 markah. Softnya ni 3 markah lah untuk satu markah. Untuk softnya ni kan. Yang awak punya operation, elementary row operation ni 3 markah. Total 5 markah. Okay, then last question, state the algebraic multiplicity and geometric multiplicity for lambda equal to negative 2. So tadi kita tahu kat sini, okay, kita dah cari lambda equal to negative 2, negative 2. So ni refer kepada dia punya algebraic multiplicity lah, AM equal to 2. So AM tadi algebraic multiplicity equal to 2. And geometric multiplicity refer kepada dia punya basis for eigenvector. So basis for eigenvector kat sini ada satu je kan. So GM equal to 1. Okay, GM equal to 1 and AM equal to 2. Betul lah kalau kita guna theorem 5 tadi, dimension AM, dimension GM always less than or equal to AM kan. GM dapat 1, less than or equal to AM 2. So proof lah theorem 5 tadi tu. Jadi GM equal to 1. Okay, ada soalan? Okay, then tengok. Kita boleh habiskan. Kita sempat habiskan. Okay, yang lain awak boleh buat sendiri. Okay, tengok info pada notes yang tadi balik. Okay, so tadi kita dah find eigenvalues and eigenvector and also GM and AM. Okay, look at another theorem. Maksudnya theorem untuk awak, untuk tahu je lah. Kadang-kadang ditanya juga dalam soalan kan. Theorem ni awak kena tahu dan ingatlah juga sikit-sikit. Okay, the theorem tu, okay, relationship between, okay, theorem semua ni boleh refer dalam textbook awak lah. Textbook awak ada. Theorem tu boleh tengok dalam textbook. Okay, notes ni saya simplify kan. Okay, theorem tu, relationship between eigenvalues and determinant. Okay, so the product of eigenvalues. Okay, lambda 1 times lambda 2, lambda 3 times lambda 3. So equal to the determinant. Determinant of A. Boleh prove kan theorem ni. The product of lambda equal to the determinant. Ini product. Product is multiplication kan. Product of lambda. So tu determinant. And the second relationship is relationship between eigenvalues and traces. Okay, so the summation of lambda. Summation. Asyik tambah. Is equal to the trace of a matrix A. Okay, trace of matrix A is the sum of main diagonal. hasil tambah main diagonal untuk matrix. Okay, we look at. Ni nak cari balik. Okay, we look at the previous example 2. Ni awak kena buat balik ni. Ni cari balik determinant saya nak tunjuk. Nak tunjuk teorem ni je lah. So teorem tu kita refer example 2 lah. So tadi mention teorem 2, first relationship between eigenvalues and determinant kan. Okay, so untuk eigenvalues tadi kita dah dapat eigenvalues equal to 3 and 2. So the product of eigenvalues equal to the determinant. So the product tadi awak dapat lambda equal to 3 and 2 kan. So product awak dapat kita dapat 3 times 2 equal to 6 kan. Okay, sama tak dengan dia punya determinant. Determinant of A yang ni. Kita cari 1, 1, -2, 4. Apa sama kan? 4 - -2 equal to 6. So proof lah untuk second theorem, theorem 2. The product of eigenvalues equal to the determinant of A. Ni matrix A. Determinant of A. Based on theorem 2 kan tadi. Theorem 2. Ni yang number 1 lah. And then the number 2 is the summation of lambda. Summation of lambda equal to the trace of A. The trace of A is the summation of main diagonal. So summation dia, okay, dapat lambda 1 plus lambda 2 ya. So 3 plus 2 equal to 5. Sama tak dengan trace A? Trace A is the sum of main diagonal of A, 1 plus 4. Trace A ni sum of main diagonal. Sum of main diagonal. So 1 plus 4 equal to 5. So proof lah untuk theorem 2. Okay. Ni untuk awak proof je lah ni. And then the theorem 3. Okay, if A is the triangular matrix, okay, either the upper triangular matrix, lower triangular matrix or diagonal matrix, so the eigenvalues equal to the value on its main diagonal. Maksudnya kat sini, awak tak perlu cari dia punya eigenvalues pun. So eigenvalues untuk triangular matrix equal to dia punya main diagonal. Contohlah, contoh kat sini kalau awak dapat matrix C kan. Contoh saya bagi matrix C equal to 2, 0, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0, 1. Matrix C equal to the diagonal matrix 2, 0, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0, 1. So the eigenvalues equal to ni lah. Awak tak perlu cari dia punya ni lah. Eigenvalues. So eigenvalues equal to, terus je senaraikan. Ni lambda kan. Betul 2, 3 and 1. Ni untuk diagonal. Kalau upper or lower triangular, contohnya saya beri. Sini. Ok, Okay, ni triangular matrix. Triangular matrix sebab dia ada ni kan. So the eigenvalues equal to main diagonal. Terus je dapat lambda equal to 1, 2, 4. Kalau awak cari guna yang biasa tu pun akan dapat jawapan yang sama lah. 1, 2, 4. Boleh. Ni kita refer kepada theorem 3 ni. In short form lah theorem 3. Solve using. Okay, yang ni awak boleh cari sendiri nanti. Ni homework lah. Find all the angles determinant A and trace of A. Example 3. Ni awak dapat nanti. Ni untuk matrix A awak dapat ni determinant. Determinant equal to negative 5. Trace equal to 4. Untuk B ni determinant dia. Trace 7. Boleh find all the eigenvalues from the eigenvalues, find the determinant and trace. Ini next class. Okay, tinggal refer theorem 6, or boleh study dulu lah, tengok textbook. Theorem 6 and the diagonalization. Lagi sikit. Okay, so hari ni sampai sini je lah. Sampai ni, trace and determinant using theorem 2 and 3. Ni soal final jaranglah, tapi ada lah juga kan tadi dan tadi tengok. Final lah boleh buat sendiri eh, dia punya ni tutorial. Yang mana yang dah boleh buat. Yang boleh buat lah tutorial latihan ni. AB diagonalizable belum lagi. So ni boleh buat AB. AB boleh buat AB. Sehingga contohnya C je lah, diagonalizable. Okay, ada soalan tak? Okay, so kita stop dulu sampai sini. Next class kita habiskan, cuba habiskan. Nanti week 14 kita akan discuss soalan pasir lah. Soalan pasir dan saya akan tunjukkan tu lah pemakaian dia. Okay, ada soalan? So, kelas hari ni sampai sini. Apa-apa ada problem ke boleh WhatsApp eh? Boleh WhatsApp saya lah, personal. Okay, you all punya you future, jangan lupa klik. Dan attendance dalam Google Form saya akan bagi dalam WhatsApp lah. Okay, so untuk Minggu ni jangan lupa eh, awak punya assessment tree, the last assessment. The assessment tree tu chapter 4 tak akan ditanya dalam final. So, untuk assessment tree, tapi untuk assessment tree banyaklah awak punya percentage 30%. Walaupun tak ditanya dalam final tapi percentage dia carry banyak banyak markah lah kan. 30%, 30 markah. Okay. Kita abang-abang selesai, kita stop sampai sini. Okay, so jumpa lagi. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye semua.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.